Now the last chemical property of ammonia is left, that is reducing property of ammonia. Now to understand this reducing property of ammonia, we have to understand this experiment. Here we have taken cupric oxide, which is black in color, and ammonia being reducing agent, dry ammonia gas is passed to this combustion tube, and already cupric oxide is heated, placed over here, black color cupric oxide, and is preheated, and then dry ammonia gas is passed. So when these two will react here, cupric oxide, when it will react with ammonia, see what is the method right now over here. Metal oxide is reduced to metal with the help of ammonia, ammonia being reducing agent. So both of them are heated, and then the product formed are cupric oxide is reduced to metal, that is copper, nitrogen and water vapor. So we are getting three products over here. Cupric oxide, black color cupric oxide, will turn to dull red metallic residue copper over here. Nitrogen and water vapor will go to this U-tube. This U-tube is immersed in cold water, so water vapor will get easily condensed, and here you are getting liquid water, and nitrogen is not soluble in water, so here nitrogen gas will not easily get condensed, and nitrogen will move to this, through this delivery tube, and by downward displacement of water nitrogen is collected, because nitrogen is insoluble in water. So this is the experiment. So here cupric oxide, which is black in color, is taken, and in this case we'll see that the balancing part, nitrogen is 2 over here, so copper is 2. So in this case we'll see that 32-33 balancing, and this black cupric oxide will turn to dull red copper, or you can say reddish brown copper is also okay, and along with that we are getting nitrogen and water vapor, which are getting condensed. And now let us understand the mechanism in this case. So here this being reducing agent, ammonia is the reducing agent, it reduces copper oxide to copper, removal of oxygen is taking place, so this substance is reduced, and ammonia itself is getting oxidized, removal of hydrogen and forming nitrogen. So this is acting as reducing agent. In all these reactions we will see that it is acting as reducing agent. Now next reaction is PbO when heated with ammonia, we'll get Pb, nitrogen and water vapor. Again, PbO is yellow in color, is also common name is yellow litharge. Here this is not taken in combustion tube because it fuses with the glass and it is difficult to remove, so it is taken in porcelain disc, and PbO is heated with ammonia, and we get silvery white metal lead. Silvery white metal lead we are getting along with nitrogen and water vapor. So these are the two reactions where we will see that metal oxide is reduced to metal with the help of reducing agent, that is ammonia. Next is reduction of bleaching powder to calcium chloride. So bleaching powder is CaOCl2, calcium oxychloride, when reacts with ammonia. Here we get, in this case also we are heating, in all this we are heating, so we get calcium chloride, nitrogen and water vapor. In this also the same balancing. Okay, so here all of the three reactions are same, and in all these three reactions you will see 32-33 balancing, and this bleaching powder is reduced to calcium chloride with the help of this ammonia, and ammonia acting as reducing agent. Now the third one is reduction of chlorine to HCl. Now here we have three reactions when ammonia and chlorine both are taken in equal amounts. These three reactions are all very important reaction. When ammonia reacts with chlorine, we get nitrogen and HCl. Now again, let us understand the mechanism over here. You see here, ammonia being reducing agent and chlorine being oxidizing agent. Here, reducing agent, this is oxidizing agent. So this being reducing agent reduces chlorine. Here addition of hydrogen is taking place. Chlorine is becoming HCl. So reduction of chlorine to HCl, and ammonia itself is getting oxidized. Removal of hydrogen is taking place. So this is what the reaction is. Reducing property of ammonia it is showing. Next is, if we are taking excess of ammonia, excess ammonia, we have three reactions over here. Excess ammonia reacts with chlorine. Always keep in mind, we are getting ammonium compound. Excess ammonia, ammonium compound, dense white fumes of ammonium chloride. Along with, we are getting nitrogen. Now see here, the balancing is not easy. Here 4 hydrogen, here 3 hydrogen. So multiples of that we have to take. If we are taking 3 4s are 12, we will do, then it will not able to. So let us say 8 3s are 24 and 6 4s are 24. And 6 chlorine here. So 3 2s are 6. Now it is balanced. So dense white fumes of ammonium chloride are seen. And the next reaction is when ammonia reacts with chlorine. And here excess chlorine we are taking. First reaction we had here excess ammonia. Now in this reaction excess chlorine. So obviously we are going to get chlorine compound. Excess ammonia, ammonium compound, excess chlorine, chlorine compound, nitrogen trichloride. And along with this we are getting HCl. Here nitrogen trichloride, a yellow oily explosive liquid. Yellow oily explosive liquid it is, and it is known as nitrogen trichloride. And now let us balance this reaction. 3 and 3 here, so it is balanced. These three reactions are very important reaction. All these reactions are showing reducing property of ammonia. Now let us understand the uses of ammonia. So fertilizers, the main use of ammonia is fertilizer. Nearly 80% of ammonia is used to manufacture fertilizers. And this fertilizers, like you can say here ammonium sulfate, ammonium nitrate, ammonium phosphate, and urea. So these are the very important fertilizers which can be prepared with the help of ammonia. Now as a source of hydrogen, hydrogen is converted into liquid ammonia and it is transported in cylinder. See, hydrogen is very difficult to transport because it is combustible gas. As hydrogen is a combustible gas, it is difficult to transport. It is difficult to transport, and that is why it is converted into liquid ammonia. So hydrogen is converted into liquid ammonia and then transported with the help of Haber's process. See, hydrogen and nitrogen combine to form ammonia, and this ammonia is then decomposed and we get hydrogen very easily. So then ammonia is decomposed. Then ammonia gas, sorry, ammonia liquid in the liquid state. So ammonia is decomposed and we get hydrogen gas. As a refrigerant in ice plants. Now in this case here, ammonia can be easily converted into liquid. It is highly volatile and easily liquefies. Ammonia easily liquefies. It is highly volatile and it has high latent heat of vaporization. High latent heat of vaporization. So what happens over here? Liquid ammonia is easily evaporated and a relatively large amount of heat is absorbed from the surrounding and the water is converted to ice. Now what happens here? Ammonia in the liquid state absorbs a large amount of heat and is converted to ammonia gas. And here you'll see that 5.7 kilocalorie heat is absorbed from the surrounding. This much heat is absorbed from the surrounding and water is easily converted. Water is converted to ice. As a cleansing agent. Now here, as a cleansing agent, ammonia solution is used for removing grease and perspiration stains from clothes. So it removes grease and stains from clothes, cleaning tiles, windows, porcelain. So here what happens? Ammonia solution we are using. So that is ammonium hydroxide. So ammonia solution means ammonium hydroxide is used to remove grease stains or perspiration stains from clothes, windows, etc. Now how it removes, the point is here, the reason behind this is ammonia solution emulsifies fats and grease. So it emulsifies fat and grease from the clothes and it breaks down the fat and grease molecules. Okay, emulsifies fat and grease means it breaks down, and this is how this stains can be removed. So these are the four important uses of ammonia, can be asked in the form of give reason. Thank you, students.